Fred Williams, technical editor at Peterson's 4-Wheel and Off-Road Magazine. This year, we built a Jeep specifically for Rick to take on Ultimate Adventure. It started out as a 76 CJ7, but all we kept was the frame, the grille, and the brake pedal. So we built the Jeep in a really short time, but we used something from everybody on our sponsors list. We started the Jeep project about 2.5 months ago. Rick's a big airplane fan, so we wanted to come up with something that was part Jeep, which is his main love, and airplanes. So we designed and built what we call the CJ-17, part Jeep, part B-17 bomber. Under the hood, we have a 430 horsepower LS3 engine from GM Performance Parts. It's one of their E-Rod engines, which is a smog legal engine, crate engine for swapping into hot rods, late model Jeeps, just about anything you want to take off road or down the highway. This thing has more power than Peiwei's ever had in a Jeep. We should be ripping it up out there all week long. And of course, 37-inch Goodyear is ready to run down the trails and down the road. We didn't have a single issue with our tires. The Warn 95XP. Warn's been great to us every year. We got a Warn winch on every project vehicle we've built for Ultimate Adventure. We're hoping we don't need to use this all week. But things happen, we just might. And Hobart, we used them to help weld up some final parts on the roll cage so the thing's dialed in. Underneath, we have BDS leaf springs. These are leaf springs, front leaf springs out of a Jeep Wagoneer. We've modified them a little bit, beefed them up, so they should be good to deal with the 430 horsepower we got to play with this year. Overkill Engineering does a full line of body armor for Jeeps. We worked with them, came up with some rock sliders specifically for this Jeep. Daystar does a whole line of polyurethane products. We use them for the transmission mount and some of the leaf spring mounts. High lift jack, there's a high lift buried in the back of that Jeep under right in front of the spare tire. This is our Warn recovery point. This is where we're gonna hook up our Bubba rope and pull the other guys out.
That's for the next guy.
We're really hoping we don't need to use this to pull ourselves out. And this is coffee. This Jeep wouldn't be done without coffee. I'm really happy with this Jeep. I think it turned out really cool. We wanted to do a Jeep that was kind of unique. It worked good, it turned out cool. It's something unique, but it's also pretty damn simple. And that's exactly what you want when you're out on a trip like this.